Hello everybody and welcome on my YouTube channel. You are with Alandris and today I'm on Heroes Charge on the test server to try for you the next event hero who will be available in the game. It's Desert Eagle.
War is like the desert, unforgiving and endless.
Desert Eagle looks like a sort of pharaon. It's an intellect hero and we will check his statistics. We will use the website hcharge.tk. Before to speak about the statistics of a Desert Eagle, two important points. First point, what you could tell us about this hero. It's a backline intellect hero who can cast a curse on the enemy, turning the enemy into a mummy to fight for him. And it's also an undead hero, so it's a pretty interesting. Second point, I want to speak about the web designer who is doing the website for a fan of Heroes Charge. He is needing your help, so if you have some bucks to help him, it will be really nice. He's paying for the server $50 per month, so it's not crazy much, I agree, but it's like a hobby for him. This site just he's doing for the community, it's not his job, so if you can give him $1, $2 in according of your own money, it will be really nice for this guy who is doing a crazy, crazy job. Now about his statistics, it's one hero with nearly 121,000 HP, 946 of armor, 817 of magical resistance. So for a backliner, he doesn't seem to be crazy squishy. We will see against Sapper if he can hold, but it seems to be not so bad. 25,197 of magical power, it's a pretty high score. 163 of ignore magic resistance, magic penetration. And finally, one interesting statistic, 350 of initial energy. It means that this hero will begin the fight with more than 33% of his own energy. He will be able to do his ultimate pretty quickly. So, before to check his position on the battlefield, let's check now his skills. Let's begin with the ultimate of Desert Eagle, Mummy's Curse. Curses an enemy causing magic damage while transferring the damage amount into his own HP and turning the enemy into a mummy. The mummies will keep attacking Horus' team and are not able to restore their HP. Increases damage by 8775 and the skill will touch in according of the level. It seems to be pretty strong because you will recover some life for a Desert Eagle, you will control one enemy, he will attack his own team and also he is not able to recover his HP during this time and he will mess the enemy configuration. So I like this skill, I'm really curious about how he will work. Second skill, the green one, suffocating sound, controls the flowing sound to suffocate an enemy, making the enemy continuously lose HP. If the enemy is not from the undead race, it will make the enemy only able to use the normal attack and unable to use skills. So these skills also seems pretty strong because it's not so much undead actually in the game, and during all the duration of this skill the enemy will just do some auto attack, so it's mean against all casters. Oh my god, it will be pretty strong. I'm also really hyped about this skill. Blue skill, Scorching Ray, releases a ray to the front enemies, causing magic damage and continuous burning damage. Increases damage by 4680 and burning by 2925 per second. So when I'm reading enemies, it means it looks like to be an area damage in the front lane. I want also to see how it's working. And finally, the purple skill, God's Punishment, causes holy damage to the killer when he is dead, making the target unable to restore the HP for the next period of time. Increases holy damage by 17,550 I will tell again, but holy damage, you can't resist about it. These damages can't be a critical hit, but it will be always the same amount, whatever it's a tank, a caster, or something else. So, this hero, when I'm reading these skills, seems to be pretty strong, is destroying all life regeneration, more or less, is controlling the battlefield, stunning some enemies, even taking the control of some enemies. So, I want to see how he's working. Let's begin by his position on the battlefield. Desert Eagle is a backliner, so we will compare with other backliners that we have in the game. So, okay, seems to be in front. Pretty nice. Okay. Some heroes are in front of him, but he's pretty in front of the backlane. Ah! Some heroes surprised me. Okay, so he's now in the middle of the back lane. Okay, so no crazy information about his position on the battlefield. He's in the middle of the back lane. So he won't be exposed directly from damage, except if you attack him with Arcane Sapper, for example, because it's an intellect hero, so he will be the main target of this kind of hero. So, let's check now his skills in action. So here it is, the skill test. So this is the green skill, directly in the beginning of the fight. Oh, the blue skill with touching even the backline. Pretty interesting. Okay. My god, these damages are amazing. And no regeneration of life because he is under the ultimate effect. It's pretty impressive. I want to see also how much damage he is dealing, but I think it's really not ridiculous. Look this dot. Oh, she's melting. Game over. Okay. And finally, 728,000 in this little fight. I'm pretty curious about what he will be able to do. So let's begin by the damage test before some real situations. So we will see, we will have a lot of skill animation time. So I don't know if the score will be far better. We get also an information. You see that the laser is touching the front lane and little behind the front lane. I will accelerate the fight. Mommy. Okay, yes, we are losing a lot of time because of the skill animation. The shield also. But we will have an indication. Finally, we will see the score. I don't know. I don't think that it's so... Yes, nearly 800,000. Oh, it's not bad for sure. Hein? But for a damage test, I was thinking that he could do better. But it doesn't matter. We will check now in real situations. First fight against one of the best meta team actually. So we will see. I think it can be really interesting because the the fact that is canceling the life regeneration can be a big problem for Arcane Sapper. You saw that he already proc finally his skin skill, and now he's under the transformation, Mumi's transformation. He's lucky Because don't forget that Barbie's skill is a removing effect of debuff. So finally, he was safe. And we will see the purple skill in action. So watch carefully, because when the Desert Eagle will die, he will deal crazy damages. Finally, he's coming. And it will come soon. Hop, next shot, pouf! And finally, Arcane Sapper is punished because he killed Desert Eagle. So, we will have the timeout, but we are 3 against 2, so we won this match, potentially. And you can see, nearly 700,000 for Arcane Sapper, but nearly 600 for Desert Eagle. It's really, really interesting and not ridiculous at all, especially against this kind of setup with Barbie with removing the debuff that he is putting. So let's try another situation. In this situation, you will see a way to counter Desert Eagle. Even if I will win this match, you will understand the problem. First, Ancien Statue skill is absorbing the skills of Desert Eagle, and also the clones of Leaf Shadow can be a big problem for Desert Eagle. So finally, you can control him like that. And you will see that he will now recover some life with his ultimate. Yup. And the fight is finished. And you can see 244,000 for Desert Eagle, so it's pretty nice. And Arcane Sapper nearly didn't do nothing in this match, where he should normally do a lot, because you have a lot of heroes who are around Amber Star, but he was well controlled. Ancien Statue was destroyed, fortunately for us, and you can see one of the way to counter Desert Eagle. So, let's try now a last situation. Last situation for today, I'm trying to pair him with some undead heroes and with Ghost Knight to get him an additional buff, and I want to see what he is able to do. Look carefully what is doing Desert Eagle, because it's pretty interesting. First, he will transform someone in a mummy. Secondly, he will survive. This is not bad against this setup. And look the dot, the damage on Ninetalefox are killing her. And finally, he's interrupting Scarlet Sickle. She proc her skills. The debuff again, so Scarlet Sickle will die alone nearly. Finally, he is dead, but he did the job, because only now Flywheel is alive, and Flywheel against 2 hero and half. 611,000 damage, and a really good control on this team, which is really difficult to control, because Ninetalefox is coming on your team, Scarlet Sickle is coming on your team, and even you receive some massive damage from Flywheel, with Turtle who is messing you. It's a really strong team, and finally, this hero can do something really useful in this situation. So, I will now give you my strengths and weaknesses for Desert Eagle. 4 points as a strength for a Desert Eagle. First point, it's one hero who has a good survivability. You saw his statistics in the beginning. Statistics are not insane, but for an intellect backliner, it's not bad at all, and it's far enough to survive, especially with the ultimate who will give you back some HP. Second point, and I think the main, this hero is crazy strong as a damage dealer. You see that he's able to do a ton of damage and to do some dots who are really, really strong. Dots damage over time. Third point, he can control and mess the battlefield. You saw that with, for example, the ultimate, you will control one enemy and transform him that he fight in your own sight. Also, you will have a suffocating sound who mainly will interrupt all skills for enemies. Only against undead it won't work. So you have something really strong, and if someone is successfully killing him, he will get as return some holy damage, some strong holy damage, and most of the time if he is low life, he will die. So it's really interesting. And the last point, little one but interesting point, this hero begins the fight with 35% of his energy and is charging pretty quickly, so mainly he's able to do his ultimate 2-3 times per fight, and it's pretty efficient for sure. I will now speak about his weaknesses. 2 points as weaknesses for a Desert Eagle. First point, it's one hero who will be pretty weak against a summoner. I mean summoner, heroes who are able to summon something. It means statue, ancienne statue, who is able to summon one stone, magic breaker, who will summon one beast, leaf shadow skin, who will summon plenty of clone, and so on. I let you imagine what you can do. Because most of the time, you will be able to turn him, so when he is turned, he will do his skills in the wrong direction. And second point, he will use his main skill, the ultimate, the green skill, against some clones who are totally useless. So finally, he's losing nearly 100% of his efficiency against this kind of heroes. And second point, actually, he is not dealing any massive damage. I mean, if you have Amber Star, for example, when she is doing her ultimate, it's 100,000, 150,000, and most of the time the enemy is dead. For Desert Eagle, it's not like that. It's a lot of damage over time and some direct damage, but not really strong. So when you are playing with him, you can see the fight by two ways. First way, you will play with a lot of support and you will kill your enemies little by little. And secondly, you need to add some heroes who will be able to add some damage to kill these targets. So it's all for strength and weaknesses. I will now give you my final opinion about Desert Eagle. I'm finally giving a strong 18 on 20 for a Desert Eagle, and I think he's pretty suitable everywhere. Be careful when you are fighting against team with some summoners, because he's losing a lot of efficiency against this setup, and that's why he's only 18 on 20 and not more. But against all setup without summoners, he will be really strong. He's controlling the battlefield, the green skill is insane, the ultimate is really interesting, he's dealing a lot of damage, and he's able to survive. And when he dies, he's punishing the heroes with killing him. So one hero that I really like, and I'm sure that this hero will appear in the metagame, because he has definitively one place. It's all for today. It's now time to conclude. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Don't forget to drop a like if you enjoyed it and to subscribe to my channel to not miss anything. You can also support my work by sharing this video, and if you feel yourself really generous, you can donate some bucks or join the new YouTube's program to sponsor me. Thanks again and see you soon. Bye bye.